I'm going to test a few antennas on the Baofeng UV-5R Mini. This is one of their latest radios. It basically gives you most all the functions of some of their most popular radios, but in a much smaller form factor. With Airband, I'm just right on the skirts of a range of an airport, how well it can be picked up. I'll show you the range you get with the stock antenna versus other antennas like these little stubby radios that a lot of people prefer to use with such a small radio. It just completes the small form factor by dropping it down by quite a bit. But I'm right on the edge of the range. Sometimes I can get the local reception from the airport. And other times I can only pick it up when I hold it in my hand on it. So with this stock antenna, which is really small and works, you know, perfect fit for this, sometimes it can come up just a little bit short. So if you're holding it in the hand, I'm about around right at 8 miles away from the airport. This antenna will work pretty good when it's in hand. Sometimes when I let it go, it'll come in and out. So that lets me know that it's sort of right on the fringe here. So if I try the smaller antenna, and it works good for a lot of situations, especially surprisingly well with FM stations on it. I can screw this little radio antenna in, one of the diamond mini ones, and I'm not getting anything with it. If I hold the metal in hand or hold on the tip of it, it uses me as an antenna. You can pick it up a little bit. If I set it down, I'm not getting anything, any reception at all. Even just touching the body, the metal part, if I grab the very end of it and hold it, I can pick it up. So it's just barely functionable in that range here with it. My go-to antenna is the Nagoya 320. It's a true tri-band antenna, so it works better with Airband. I'm going to give this Baofeng K6 antenna a try. It's a little bit bigger than the stock antenna, but this antenna comes with a few of their standard size radios with them. Now I'm going to test the Baofeng K6 antenna, see how well it does. A little bit of volume here. This antenna comes on a few of their different Baofeng radios, the ones that are more of a medium size radio. This one picks up pretty good. You see here, it's got a, in the corner, it tells you the strength with it. Seems to work pretty good. So it definitely works slightly better than the stock antenna on the Mini here. See how it compares to my 320, which is my favorite go-to antenna. And this is a little bit longer whip antenna, flexi, but you can sort of fold it over, store it away. It's easier to carry than some of these other longer antennas, but this is supposed to be a true tri-band antenna, and for me, it's always worked really well, as long as you make sure that you get the original real version instead of one of the counterfeit ones that you can find occasionally on AliExpress. So this one actually works a little bit better when you're not holding, touching the antenna. You hold the body, it works fine. Holding the end of it really doesn't make a difference in strength. It actually weakens the signal a little bit. So if you want probably the best antenna that's going to work with this in the Airband, the 320 is sort of hard to beat. The little stubby antenna, this will work with FM radio stations pretty good, but unless you're really close with a super strong signal, it doesn't seem to work terribly great with this Mini radio. The stock antenna's definitely a step up, and it'll work better with Airband. This one's a little bit stronger with the K6 antenna, but not much. It's not worth the difference stepping up from the stock antenna that comes with, and definitely the 320 antenna works much better. So I'll put links to the antennas in the description below, and if you want one of them, just click it below. If this helped you out at all, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.